Waterfall, let's get ready this cold day. Let's do our nice warm up. Here we go. Let's go to some bad kids. Let's do some skipping, and we're going to start backward. Let's do open the gate and close the gate. Now let's close the gate. I do something new. It's called bounding. Straight legs and you're just kicking. And a couple sprints. So we're gonna go backward and forward three times. At first, 50% speed. Now let's go about 75% speed. Now let's go about full speed. Alright, let's do a few rotations to make sure we get our whole body here. Okay. Shoulders. Backward. And let's go forward. All normally it would be maybe doing 10 or so. Okay, open and close. Let's go down and do a little bit of core. Single hit. And double hit. Alright, let's do some tilts. So reach up and reach down. And then reach up and reach down. Reach, go past the head. Past the head. Pass the shoulder, pass the shoulder, and all the way, all the way. Final thing for the hip flexors, just a couple lunges with raises. It's called crescent pose. I do three of them. Shake it up, and we're ready to go. All right, for our trapping drill of the day, we're gonna do some trapping and shielding. If you're alone, all you have to do is toss the ball, okay? Trap it, and then shield it by turning around and protecting from behind. Again, let's see it. First to the left foot. You trap, get this, and then you bring it back. And now let's try with the right foot. You trap, you put the ball up, you turn it around, and you shield. You can do it by catching it in the air. You toss the ball out, you trap, turn around, and then you shield. It's on the other side. Toss, trap, turn around, and then shield. All right. The final one you can try to do is get the ball in the air with your feet. Left foot, drop, and shield. Now we're going to do the other foot. Drop, and shield. Try to do 5 of each of these ones. Alright, good job. Shield the ball from your opponents. For our dribbling of the day, we're going to try this U-shaped dribble where you do one pullback, okay, so you pull the ball back like this. Then you move the ball laterally. You can do it two ways. You either move it this way, right, so you do just a slight touch to the side, or you can do it behind the back because you can pull it behind you, okay, and then you move it this way. And then the third move is simply going to be a touch pull. Alright, so it looks like this. You can start right here. Pull back, shift it over, pull forward. Pull back, shift it over, go forward. So let's do 5 in a row. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. You want to get easier and protect the ball, you do behind the back. It's called the point. So you basically pull the ball back, and then with the side, you roll it behind and forward. Alright, let's do 5 of these. Back, around, forward. Back, around, forward for 2. Back, around, forward. Back, around, forward. And one more. Back, around, forward. Hopefully this helps. Try a lot of these because it's important to know how to dribble the ball in really tight spaces.
A precise pass, we're going to try to use the inside of our foot, so the instep, and I set up 3 different targets so that we can practice our direction. The most important thing that we have to look at is to go through the ball and end the motion in the direction of our target. So if the camera was the target right now, I would try to hit the ball right in the middle, okay, with the open foot. And then as you see my foot will continue in the direction of the camera. So with the orange target, for example, what I'm going to do is I'm going to make sure that my foot is always in it's always projecting between the orange cone.
All right, let's try a few with the left foot and a few with the right foot. Here we go.
Good.
Right now, do it slowly, focus on the follow through.
Good. Okay, opened up the foot a little too much. That's a lot better.
One more. Okay, as you see, my follow through is correct. I'm gonna go with the right foot. At the end, I curled my foot in, which was not ideal. It's when I closed the foot. And one more. Good. I hope this gives the idea. Once you get comfortable with a single target and with a static motion of passing, you can start to move around and try with a couple different targets. So right now I'm going to do a few rounds where I have the orange targets, the dark blue targets, and the light blue targets. Now I'm going to try a few passes with the left foot and a few passes with the right foot. All right, let's see.
With the right.
You get the idea. Maybe try with some of your friends and see who can get most in a row without a mistake. All right, for our shooting today, we're going to do what is called the finishing. So finishing happens when you just score a goal on a ball that has been crossed to you close to the goal. So usually it's fairly easy, it's not a difficult shot. What is difficult is to time the ball right. So the ball may be coming in, maybe bouncing right in front of you, or it may require a volley. A lot of times it's just a push in. So the way you can practice it, aside from what you saw in the video, is simply like this. You dodge the ball, and when it bounces, you push it in. You dodge the ball, and of course, every time you can make it gradually more difficult. So for example, you can keep the ball right as it bounces. So like this. You can also toss the ball further away so that you have to chase it. So like this. And then you can do a few where you just toss the ball in the air and hit a volley. For example, a straight volley, like this. Or even a side ball, like this. All right, have fun with these finishes. It doesn't matter how close you are to the goal. It only matters how good of an impact you have and how good your timing is on the ball. All right, practice this shot.
For our goalkeeping today, we're gonna look at diving saves, or in any case, at saves that are not close to our bodies. In the first two photos here displayed, one of which is this one, you will see that the first thing that touches the ground is the knee of the goalie. Then goalies extend their bodies and their hips go down, maybe helped by a hand or an elbow in this case. In any case, the ball is protected, but so is the body. Oftentimes, after making contact with the ball, goalies don't try to keep the ball in their hands, but they let it fall in front of them and they go for a second protection, if they have time. At higher level, of course, some shots are so difficult to save that you have to go in full flight mode, and that's obviously a spectacular thing and also what makes the role so exciting. For this stage, however, let's stick to the sequence: knee, hip, elbow, and ball protection.
One feature that is really effective when designing offensive plays
is the give and go. The give and go is a type of passing that occurs, obviously, between two players, and it's a quick type of pass. So one player has the ball, gives it to the other player, and then the original passer keeps running straight. So the receiver will then close the pass in the form of a triangle. Easier seen than explained. So let's see how this give and go works. Now let's imagine that this orange cone is our opponent. So what I do is the opponent, for example, is coming a little bit towards me, right? I decide to pass to my teammate, go past the opponent, and now receive the ball when my opponent is behind me, all right? So let's practice a few at home where you just do this and get the ball and continue running. Then you turn around, this, continue running, get the ball. Hit it, continue, get the ball. Left foot, continue, get the ball. I hope you get the idea, because the give and go is a tool that is used quite a bit. And this agility drill is called the box jumps, because usually it's done on top of a box, so like a stepper or some elevator. Now here I do it with the two cones, and I'm just gonna count whenever I'm back in the middle. So I'm starting in the middle, jump out, jump back in, and that's one. Out, in, that's two. I have 20 seconds to do as many as I can. All right, let's see it. Start in the middle. And go. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, and 5. All right, 25, that's pretty good. You can definitely get up to 30. Running, but it's also about good balance. So today we're actually going to work a little bit on our leg balance. This might be challenging for some. It's called the half moon, and it's actually a yoga pose. How do you do a half moon? You're going to start standing like this, and you're going to slowly lean down towards the ground. You're going to place your hand on the ground and be nice and solid, and you're going to try to lift the leg and straighten your leg. Okay? Left leg up, right leg straight. And now, in order to get in the half moon pose, we're going to raise our arm and hold. See how you're doing with that. If there's no problem, maybe try to look up. If you're that good, maybe try to come off a little bit and see if you can go without the hand, but like really close to the ground. Now I feel really challenged. All right. Okay, this side will be okay. We're gonna try to stay up on the left side. I'm gonna place my weight on the left leg, go down with my hand, open hand, lift the right leg, nice and straight, straighten the left leg, raise my right arm, and now I'm in the basic pose. This is the half moon. Open up your chest, and if you wanna challenge yourself again, look up. You want to challenge yourself even more? Lift up that hand and see if you can wiggle your fingers. It's all good. I haven't fallen yet, so I'm going to safely come down, put my foot down, and this was your half moon pose. Work on that, because a good balance on your legs is going to make you a better